Hello, Malty, mad malevolent Malty Minotaurs, and thank you to AKS Padded for the malt mention. Or maybe it's AK Spadded or Spaded. Anyway, if you're out there, you know who you are. Welcome to the Bothy Malt Mates for Ralfy Review 789 Extras, in which, apart from reviewing quality spirits and sharing my experience with you, I help you gain your experience on your journey with your spirits by providing a little bit additional insight which I have picked up on my journey down the malt road. Rightio. Now, it doesn't take very long before we discover, particularly with Scotch whisky, but also with many other spirits made around the world, that the best metal to make into a still is copper. And one of the primary reasons is that copper is highly conductive. Stainless steel, it's conductive as well. Ceramics, by the way, can be quite conductive, and you do get ceramic stills in Mexico and Africa. But certainly in the case of Scotch whisky, all, without exception, all pot stills, traditional pot stills, are made of copper, good quality copper. And it's not simply because it's a good conductor of heat. And it's a relatively soft metal and easy to work into unusual shapes, which we do find with some of these stills out there. But importantly, it has natural properties which affect alcohol, particularly in the process of it being made. And you'll hear before too long that one of the properties of copper is that it softens the harsh edges of, and it reduces the anger of a new made spirit. That's a really good way of putting it. It reduces the anger of a new made spirit and makes it calmer and more expressive as it comes out the still. Not only that, but any sulfides and unwanted savoury notes or cheesy notes or fainty notes are suppressed quite proactively, because the alcohol interacts with the metal in the copper. Copper is a metal, beg your pardon. And these are reduced, which is why some distilleries, like, for example, Mortlach, are still using worm tub coolers, where you've got a massive big wooden tub outside the wall of the distillery, and this big foot wide diameter, roughly, pipe winding its way round down into the cold water coming out the river and cooling the vapour from the stills, condensing it into new make spirit. And over the years, various distilleries have tried replacing their cooling system, where essentially there was less prolonged copper activity with the condensing spirit, and found that they actually got more unpleasant liquor, so they resorted back to the original way of cooling, which was there for a purpose in the first place. So we should never lose sight of tangible tradition for too long, and it would be a very sorry day if they stopped using copper for stills. Copper's very important, and I think, I don't want to go into too much detail about electrical exchanges and all the rest of it, but certainly when the benefits of copper are discussed, they're discussed superficially, but there's actually quite a complex chemical, holistic interaction between new make spirit and copper, which we can, to a little bit of it, to a certain extent, experience ourselves in our own whisky bothies at home. So what you do is you go on to eBay and you do a search for Ayurvedic, which is ancient Indian medicine, Ayurvedic copper what's that called again? Tumbler, right? A pock-upper tumbler. And they're not expensive. And while you're at it, you may as well get yourself a matching copper jug. Now, over time, you're going to have to give these a clean. But if you're a malt fan, you'll enjoy cleaning your copper in your malt stash corner of your home. So this is about £20-25, but it's decent made, contains about a litre of water. Interestingly, and this is where it does get interesting, many people in India use copper to store water because it sterilises it, and it is believed that copper stored water is so activated after 6 hours in the jug that it will balance your doshas. Now, I'm no medicine man. I do recommend Harataki, and I do recommend Ashwagandha. If you're getting into your Ayurvedic remedies, they definitely have some very important lessons to teach us globally. That's a fact. But certainly sticking to whiskey, to be able to go online and get some simple copper utensils that are genuine raw copper. And you can also get these water flasks, there we go, with screw tops. You can get these in different shapes, by the way. I got the nice one. I use this for my water for my gym. And it's been discovered that certain viruses, many viruses actually, hepatitis is a good example, influenza viruses, when they come into contact with copper, they're killed. So that copper work tops in some restaurants, used in some restaurants, when they swabbed them, they discovered a much, much lower percentage of viruses than on standard marble worktops, veneered worktops, or even stainless steel worktops. The most sanitary material to use for avoiding germs is copper. So, they're inexpensive. Why don't you get yourself some, less than the cost of a bottle of whiskey? You've got, once you've bought it, you've got it for life. Next question is, you're drinking your water out your copper tumbler. Does the water taste different? In my opinion, it does. I'm not going to go into too much detail about it, but I find from using this for about 8 months now, well, it's longer really, that it makes the water crisper. It gives a certain crispness. It's not quite metallic, but I recommend you don't store the water too long in copper. Just store it for a day. That should do. But we all know that different waters affect the performance of malts. This is why some very keen aficionados, malt mates, are rather partial to getting bottled water from the source, which they take home to add to the whiskey. So, for example, all these peat heads going to Islay for Fiseal will take a few glass bottles, got to be glass, and fill them up from the springs around the island, usually the one next to Brochladdy, because that's the one everybody knows about. And we'll take it home and swear blind that it actually improves the flavour of the whiskey when you use the water that's sourced from near the distillery. Now, I think that's certain conjecture, but I'm not dismissing it, no way. Different waters affect whiskies and give not just different flavours, but different experiences. So when you add a little bit of this crisp copper stored water to a whiskey, in my opinion, it does slightly modify and round off the flavours in the malt. It opens up the whiskey slightly quicker, but not a lot, but slightly quicker. But the primary benefit from using copper stored water in your whiskey, which was produced in a copper pot still, is that there seems to be some sort of sympathetic resonance Can I get really kind of left field about this, Malt Mates? You don't think I'm going to go, I'm not going to get all woo-woo on you. I'll try not to. But it's almost as if it kind of articulates and clarifies and rounds off a single malt, rendering it a little bit more eventful. There's not a lot in it, but to a seasoned, experienced nose and palate, you will notice a difference. I'm Ralfy. I'm done and dusted here. I'm going to go and finish off this delightful Linkwood that I reviewed recently, and which is tasting even more delightful since I poured some copper infused water into the glass. And there, malt mates, you have it. We'll see you soon. Click like if you liked. Click dislike if you disliked. I'm neither up nor down about that. Leave a comment if you'd like to. Subscribe if you haven't. And go and watch my other channel, which is starting to grow up a little bit now as I settle down and get into my stride. You see, it's not just about whiskey. I'm doing my philosophy stuff as well at Fitter Philosophy. I'm just giving a wee passing plug. I won't be plugging it every review. Just mention it now and again, occasionally. Malt mates, thanks for watching.